Hi guys, we're here in Liverpool and we're covering No Limits ABC show tonight. Some of these kids are going to be the stars of the future, fingers crossed, if they stay dedicated. And yeah, we're looking forward to it. Just been speaking with Dan, who's one of the coaches there. Some really good talent on, so like I said, we're going to be interviewing the kids, giving them a bit of exposure and just giving back to the grassroots of the sport a little bit, giving away some PIQ punch trackers to the boxer of the night. And yeah, really looking forward to it. It's been a while since I've been to an amateur show, especially in Liverpool, but I used to box around the scene myself as an amateur, so like I said, it's nice to be back amongst it and seeing the kids and how excited they are, the proper buzzing for it. So yeah, really looking forward to it, and we'll give you some action and a couple of interviews soon in a bit.
Tech doctor, maybe an actress, but nothing comes easy. It takes much practice. Like, I met a woman who's becoming a star. She was very beautiful, leaving people in awe. Singing songs, Lena Horne, but the younger version. Hung with the wrong person, got a strong one at her. When cocaine, sniffing up drugs, all in the nose. Could have died so young, now looks ugly and old. No fun, cause now when she reaches for hugs, people hold their breath, cause she smells of corrosion and death. Watch the company you keep and the crowd you bring, cause they came to do drugs and you came to sing. So if you're gonna be the best, I'ma tell you how. Put your hand in the air and take the vow. I know I can,
I know I can,
be what I wanna be,
be what I wanna be.
If I work hard at it,
if I work hard at it,
I'll be where I wanna be.
So with a couple of skills bouts in, kids have just been doing like 3 1-minute rounds. For anybody who doesn't know what a skills bout is, sort of builds the kids' confidence and stuff, gets them used to being in the ring. So 3 1-minutes, like I said, it just builds the confidence and they can go on to sort of full bouts. So we've had 3 of them so far. Quite impressed by some of the little kids actually. They're quite talented for little kids, so it'll be good when they start getting into the sort of full rounds and stuff like that, which I'm sure will be soon for some of them. Some of them are a bit too shy to have an interview. They're not the easiest things. It's not like interviewing pros. You're used to pros just obviously being forthcoming. It's what they do for a job, but obviously these kids, it's all new to them. So like I said, we're just trying to give them a bit of exposure and get them used to the limelight for when the world champions themselves, fingers crossed. So yeah, enjoying it so far. Like I said, we've got some proper bouts on soon. Skills bouts are finished and start going on to the 3-2s and stuff like that. Couple more schoolboys. Then we've got some youths, which used to be junior, but now it's youth apparently. And then I think we've got one senior bout on. There's supposed to be 2, but the other guy pulled out, so should be a good one as well. So yeah, I'll keep showing you some bits and bobs and some clips and some of the interviews all the time. And yeah, see you in the next one.
Get it all in perspective. For all y'all enjoyment, a song y'all can step with. Y'all appointed me to bring rap justice, but I ain't 5-0, y'all know it's Nas, yo. Grey Goose and a whole lot of hydro only describe us as soldier survivors. Stay laced in the best, well dressed with finesse in the white tee, looking for wifey. Thug girl who fly and talk so nicely, put her in the coupe so she can feel the nice breeze. We could drive through the city, no doubt, but don't say my car's topless, say the titties is out. Newness, here's the anthem, put your hand up that you shoot with, count your loot with. Push the pool stick in your new crib, same hand that you hoop with. Swing around like you stupid, king of the town, yeah I been that. You know I click clack, where you and your men's at? Through the smurf, through the wop, baseball bat. Rooftop like we bringin' 88 back. They shootin',
Oh, I made you look. You a slave to a page in my rhyme book. Getting big money, playboy, your time's up. Where them gangsters, where them dimes at? They shooting. Oh, I made you look. You a slave to a page in my rhyme
book. Hi, it's Reece here, boxing guru. I'm here with Joel Dewar. Just had a brilliant win. How did you feel in there, mate?
Feeling good, you know. Just now I'm just a bit fatigued, like, but feeling good, yeah. Great.
And do you want to just tell the viewers on Boxing Guru just a bit of your background? I mean, what number fight was that for you then?
It was my seventh.
Right, yeah.
Seventh fight, yeah. And, yeah, I was great. I'm 6-2 at the moment. Still climbing the ladder. Still climbing up the ladder, like, but hopefully I can get to where I want to get.
I think, personally, you started the rounds really well, really sharp. Really impressed with your footwork.
Yeah.
Started to switch off at times. Yeah. Seeing you get a bit of a telling off in the corner.
Yeah, yeah, I know.
But yeah, I think at times you was just levels above.
Yeah.
Is there anything you feel like you need to improve on going forward?
Yeah, just need to stay focused all the time. Even in the third, just stay focused. Just do what I did in the first round, really. Because obviously, in the second and third, I got proper tired and everything. But I think I just need to come probably just get myself sharp.
Yeah,
when I'm in the second and the third, and keep working on. I always kept on getting shots, getting cold shots whilst I was not moving around. And get what I mean.
Yeah, yeah.
So when I started throwing shots, yeah. You know, get caught up. So I just need to focus on moving around.
Onwards and upwards, mate.
Yeah,
on to the next one.
Thank you, mate.
And everybody give this guy a follow on Instagram. What's your Instagram handle, mate?
Joel Dewar 1.
Right, and just spell Dewar, because I know someone's going to get that wrong because we did it before.
D-E-W-A-H.
Right, cheers, guys. Joel Dewar.
Thank you, mate.
Cheers, man.
So, I kind of exerted all my energy in the first round, but yeah. I got through it eventually. I was 5-time world champion kickboxer before boxing.
Right.
So my dad wanted me to move to boxing because he knew I'd do better here.
Yeah.
So I moved on. Now we're just boxing now. 12 bouts.
Yeah.
7 victories, 5 bouts.
Happy days, mate.
Yeah.
It's all experience though, isn't it?
Yeah,
the amateur game, you just need to fight anyone, everyone.
Professional is just a different thing, so I'm preparing myself for professional.
Well, exactly.
Eventually.
Are they aspirations for the future, professional game?
Yeah, professional, be the best in my league.
Yeah. Right, okay, happy days. And what weight are you at the moment?
Light welterweight.
Light welterweight. Professional light welterweight division in a few years.
Watch out.
This man. We've got a big fight coming up this weekend, Tyson Fury and Deontay Wilder.
Yeah.
What's your thoughts on that fight? How do you think it's going to go?
I've got two predictions.
Right, okay.
I'd say Deontay Wilder, during the early round, he could knock out Tyson Fury. But if it goes all the way, Tyson Fury would win.
On
points.
Fantastic. Well, put your bets on.
Yeah.
If they don't come in, then come knocking on Maz's door, not mine. But yeah, that's it, boys. Cheers, Maz.
Cheers, Maz.
Right, I'm here with little Danny Hamilton. How's it going, mate?
All right.
Yeah, good little performance there that tonight, pal. Do you want to tell the fans how many fights you've had? And
I've had 6 skills and this is my first proper bout.
Right, so first proper bout. How's you feeling there? Do you feel the skills have got you up to speed and now? Do you feel confident going into that?
I feel that I'm more confident than I ever have.
Yeah, happy days. And what do you think of your opponent in there? It was a tough fought scrap. You boxed well, but obviously went back and forth at times.
Yeah.
How do you feel?
I thought it was a proper brawl, but he was a pretty good fighter, but I got the better of him.
We've got a big fight coming up this weekend. We've got Fury and Wilder. Who have you got for that, mate?
I've got Fury.
Fury? And why is that? What does the fight going to play out?
I reckon Fury's going to move and use all of his feet because he's got the better advantage with his feet. The Wilder's just got that over that one. It's me then, you're Fury. Fury can do anything.
Exactly, mate. Mate, I love it, mate. On the same page with me. So anyway, Danny Hamilton.
Well in, Dan.
His first win and his first proper bout. And onwards and upwards, mate. Look forward to seeing you again. Yeah. World champion in the future.
Yep.
I fuck with your soul like ether. Well, teach you the king, you know you not. Godson across the belly. Lose. I prove you lost already. Brace yourself for the main event. Y'all impatiently waiting. It's like an AIDS test. What's the results? Not positive. Who's the best? Pac, Nas, and Big. Ain't no best. East, West, North, South, floor style greetings. I embrace y'all with napalm. Blows up, no guts. Left chest, face gone. How can I be garbage? Send me autos at your cottage. Burner at the side of your dome. Come out of my throne. I got this. Lock since 9-1. I am the truest. Name a rapper that I ain't influenced. Gave y'all chapters, but now I keep my eyes on the Judas. With the wine, soapy fame. Kept my name in his music. Check it. I fuck with your soul like ether. Will. Teach you the king, you know you not. Godson across the belly. Lose. I prove you lost already. Ayo, pass me the weed. Put my ashes out on these niggas, man. Hey yo, you faggots, y'all kneel and kiss the motherfucking ring. Fuck with your soul like ether. Will. Teach you the king, you know you not. Godson across the belly. Lose. I prove you lost already. I've been fucked over, left for dead, distant, forgotten. Luck ran out. They hope that I be gone stiff and rotten. Y'all just piss on me, shit on me, spit on my grave. Talk about me, laugh behind my back, but in my face. Shot some well wishing, friendly acting, envy, hiding snakes. With your hands out for my money, man, how much can I take when the streets keep calling? Heard it when I was asleep that this gazy and Cockefeller Records wanted beef. Started cocking up my weapon, slowly loading up this ammo to explode it on a camel and his soldiers. I can handle this Fidolo and his manuscript. Just sounds stupid when KRS already made an album called Blueprint. First Biggie's your man, then you got the nerve to say that you better than Big. Dick sucking lips, won't you let the late great veteran live? Will not. Godson across the belly, I prove you lost already. The king is back. Where my crown at? Ill will, rest in peace, let's do it, niggas. Fuck with your soul like ether. Will. Teach you the king, you know you not. Godson across the belly, I prove you lost already. Y'all niggas deal with emotions like bitches. What's sad is I love you, cause you're my brother. You traded your soul for riches. My child, I've watched you grow up to be famous. And now I smile like a proud dad watching his only son that made it. You seem to be only concerned with dissing women. Were you abused as a child, scared to smile, they called you ugly? Well, life is harsh, hug me, don't reject me, I'll make records.
By the anonymous Egyptian Thomas in the red corner.
And then when I found out that they weren't wearing red cards anymore,
everyone's getting caught now, isn't it?
Boss
bout that, mate. Take it easy.
Well then, lad. Alright, it's Reese, boxing guru. We've just had the final fight of the night. It was senior, Joe Thomas. Joe, it was a little bit of a slow start in that first round, but you pulled it back in the end.
Yeah, no, I thought, I'll be honest, I threw the first round away. I didn't come out, I didn't switch on. My jab wasn't stiff enough. He came out, he must have warmed up a lot better than I did, because he came out and put through a few really stiff jabs in my face and thought, well, I'm in a fight here, like.
Yeah.
So I came out and gave away the first, and after that I think I started to adapt in the second.
Yeah, yeah.
Second was pretty close, but it's, I think, I might have just tipped it from my pressure and my fitness and the work rate, and then in the third I felt like he was being very negative, boxing the back foot a lot, and I thought, I'm going to get my coach said to him in the corner after the second, he went to get into a fight now.
Yeah, so I think you could have got that stoppage in the end. It was close, but yeah. Like I said, it was a big turnaround from that first round. It was major. Just what you're looking at going forward now, have you got ABAs coming up into next year?
Yeah, that was bout number 10 for me now,
right.
And I've just boxed in the under 10s development, ABAs, a couple of months back, and I won the Merseyside and Cheshire welterweight title. And I got beaten the quarters of the nationals. So it's going forward next year, under 20s development, nationals, and hopefully I want to go one step further in a regional title, and I want to go on to box
national finals
and box for England and replicate the type of things that idols of mine have done.
Any dreams for the programme in the future after
you've done? Yeah, definitely. That's always the dream. Always the dream is to go pro, because you grow up watching the sports and you grow up watching the pros, and it's only through watching the pros that you get into the amateur game, and it's the love for the pro game that pulls you into the amateur game, and that's always the end game for me. It's to turn pro and win titles, because you always want to be like the men you idolise growing up.
You'll be massive by then. You'll be fighting on Boxing Guru TV by then. Deontay Wilder, Tyson Fury, how do you see that going?
I think
if the Fury that beat Klitschko shows up, I think Fury wins it. But I don't think you can go from having that length of time out to 2-3 years.
Yeah,
You know, getting out of shape, the weight he puts on, and that in the meantime, Wilder was fighting, training, winning world title defenses. You know, his record might be a bit padded at times, but he's now stepped up. He's beat like Ortiz, who's a very, very classy fighter, old but very classy fighter. And I think I just think them years out for Fury might catch up to him.
Yeah, you can never write off Wilder's power as well. It's phenomenal.
He's dangerous to the last bell.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So congratulations, Joe.
Thank you very much.
And all the best for the future, buddy.
Thank you very much.
Hopefully we'll see you in the pro game.
Cheers, Joe.
See you later, guys.